we are very happy to welcome you back. And I'm told to remind you that in this sector there's no retirement. So unless it's just to have a retirement party so we can bring the sector together the way this has brought all of us together in all our diversities, then maybe we can allow you to retire every year and keep coming back. So ladies and gentlemen, Martin Luther King once said, everybody can be great because anybody can serve. You don't have to have a college degree to serve. You don't have to make your subject and verb agree to serve. You only need a heart full of grace and a soul generated by love. And that, Terry, you have exemplified this for us, especially for those of us who are coming behind you. I'll start off by inviting Mr. Njonjo Mue, the chair of the International Section for Jurists, Kenya, who will say a few kind words. Njonjo, karibu.
Good evening. I'm here wearing two hats. You'll have noticed the program said Sam Mohochi, the executive director of ICJ. Unfortunately, he couldn't make it, and I was delighted to step in his position. So I just want to say a few words to Willie on behalf of ICJ Kenya, which I am privileged to chair. ICJ, as you all know, or some might not remember, is technically the oldest CSO in Kenya, having been founded in 1959, although there was a long period of lull before it emerges in the early 1990s. And ICJ has worked to promote and protect human rights, democracy, and the rule of law. And in that capacity, we are particularly grateful to you, Will, for your support in our work and the work of those other CSOs who work on judicial reforms when you have been at the head of the judiciary. And especially for the improved access to justice for the poor and marginalized through the operationalization of the court users committees. Thirdly, and everyone who talks about your leadership in the judiciary keeps saying this, that you have truly transformed the culture of the judiciary and demystified the office of the Chief Justice. And we thank you for maintaining the open door policy that you have kept during your tenure. Willie and I worked together, or rather I was privileged to be a part of the movement that Willie and Kivutha Kibwana co-convened in the mid-1990s as we pushed for a new people-driven constitution at the time when Moi was telling us that only parliament could reform the constitution. And we marched together in Saba Saba, Nane Nane, Tisa Tisa, Kumi Kumi in 1997. And those were the days, of course, we got our inspiration not only from Willie and Kivutha Kibwana, who are our co-conveners, but also Reverend Timothy Njoya and other guiding lights. And those of us who are, like George says, who are very young at the time, and who are more at home in the streets, as Boniface Mwangi clearly is these days, we were inspired by those who are the brain trust of the movement, those who not only had patience, but we could trust them because we knew that they always had our backs. And Willie was clearly one of those, especially Willie Mutunga and Dr. Kivutha Kibwana. I want to say just one thing. Somebody has already said, first of all, I congratulate the Kenya Human Rights Commission for your convening powers. There are many people here that I haven't seen for a long time. The people who have been in the movement for a long time. And I thank you for having brought us together. Willie, I thank you for this opportunity to convene the young and old of the human rights movement. And so we are here saying that we are committing ourselves to keep marching, to keep fighting until the battle is won. As finally, as for you, Willie, as Regina was saying, we are not here to say farewell, because you are not going anywhere. As a soldier of justice, You're just living to match with a different detachment of the same army. And in that new calling, we wish you all the best and God's blessings. I thank you.
Thank you very much, Jojo.